Well, welcome back to Scouting for History, and today I'm at this beautiful house built back in 1905, but even more magnificent is this tree behind me. Now, it's over 350 years old. It's a historic tree. Sorry for the traffic noise. It's over 350 years old. There's a plaque on it. Now, I can't show you the plaque because it tells you where I am, but beautiful, beautiful old oak tree. So, let's see what we can find at this house from 1905. Stay tuned. And the first find of the day is a penny. On to the next. And now a second signal. Not sure what it is. Might be just a piece of trash. I'll clean it up. If it's anything interesting, you'll see it right here. On to the next. The woman that lives here and gave me permission said that 25 years ago her husband lost his wedding ring in the yard. So hopefully we can find that and get it back to them. So let's see. On to the next. And now a tiny little rifle casing. Looks like a 22. Not surprising, back in the day it was all farm. On to the next. And another relic. I find lots of these. My house has these too. It's a bracket that goes on the wall, and there's a rod that goes from one to the other. Holds curtains. Brass. Sounds great. On to the next. And now a surface find. Outstanding. Cool little marble. On to the next. I'm not sure what it is. It sure looks like it's silver. Weighs like silver. I'll clean up and see if I can't figure it out. On to the next. Now, right up the street is a tavern that was built in the 1730s. It was a tavern up until the late 1800s. So there's a chance we could find some really old stuff here. Now, I've knocked on the door. That's just a penny. I've knocked on the door down there, and one of my rare no's. But hey, this was all part of it. It's less than a block away. About 100 yards away. So, and this tree was here back then, so let's see what we can find. On we go. And those jumpy signals that you can't get a clear reading on, sometimes they're awesome. There's a key. I'll see if the homeowners want that. That would look great in my collection, but I think it would be better to stay with the house. On to the next. Well, I told the woman if I find a gold wedding ring, I'd be happy to return it. But this is not a gold wedding ring. That is a beautiful little ring. Oh, the turquoise or whatever is broken, but that's a beautiful little silver ring. Let's keep looking for that gold one. That's a kid's ring. On to the next. And the first obvious silver of the day, and it's a Washington. That's okay, it's silver. On to the next. Now this sounds like a silver dime, so I brought the camera out. Missed it
by that much.
Missed it by a little bit. and it is just a wheat penny. So copper is a good conductor. That's why the copper pennies ring up so high. But silver is a good conductor too. Let's find some. On to the next. And the second silver of the day is just a rosy. On to the next. Well, I'm going to have to check the hole carefully because that sounded awful. It's a silver rosy again, but it rang up really low. So there's probably something else in the hole. I'll double check. On we go. Well, I'm chasing pull tabs and nickels looking for this gold ray. No luck yet. Let's keep going. It took me forever to find it because I accidentally turned the pinpointer on. That's why I couldn't find it. And it's a merc. Awesome. I'll clean it up. You'll see it right here. Turning out to be a pretty good day. Off we go. On to the next. And now another rosy. Looking for something a little old. On to the next. Well, second jewelry for the day, but it's not a gold ring. I don't even think it's gold. I think it's aluminum or something. It's very, very light. And I'll clean it up. You'll see it right here. On to the next. Well, I'm finding lots of jewelry, but no gold rings. There's another silver ring. A little one. On to the next. I thought for sure I had it, but it's a ring with a bear on it, or a wolf or something. That's cool. I'll clean it up. You'll see it right here. And another key, not quite as old as the last one, but it's still pretty old. On to the next. It came out so dirty I thought it was a penny. It's a barber. On to the next. And I thought I had it again, but no, it's just a religious medallion. Not precious, I don't think. On to the next. And again, chasing ring signals, but it's just a buffalo. Oldest nickel I've found so far. On to the next. The other day I found a tiny little fabric wing. Now I found a giant one. This is the usual size. On to the next. Boy Scout neckerchief slide. It's not too old. It's the bendable kind. Probably from the 80s or 90s. On to the next. Now down here by the curb, another merc. On to the next. Kid can be a kid. Chuck E. Cheese token. On to the next. Well, another ring-shaped thing.
not what I'm looking for. On to the next. I can't wait for the new Nokta Pinpointer to come out, because I dug this. It sounded really great, and I found a nail. But the new Nokta Pinpointer is supposed to be able to give you a good signal for silver or non-ferrous targets. It's another Washington. That's okay. I'll take it. On to the next. I can't see anything on it, but it might be a dog tag. I'll clean it up and see. On to the next. On the surface, it's a war nickel. 35% silver. Awesome. On to the next. Well, that's going to do it for today's adventure under this beautiful tree. Not a bad day. But sadly, I didn't get the guy's ring. I just talked to him. He said I could come back anytime and look again. So we'll be back. Stay tuned. Don't forget, hit like and subscribe. We'll see you then.